Yeah, good afternoon every one of you. Let's start this class.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hi, good afternoon. Okay, in the morning I will just summarize this one. Okay, then leaching problem, continuous countercurrent extract leaching they have given. So we don't know how many stages are there inside this overall battery or a stack. Then from the given data, in the given data they have given in the feed or unreacted meals or untreated meal. So A is equal to 30 kg, meaning the solvent is already there inside the feed seeds with B, completely bone dried inert solids as 1000 kg. Then inside that seeds, the 365 kg oil is there, which is C. Then the solvent is not a pure solvent, which is a solution, which is composed of solute plus solvent. 14 kg of solute is there, which is oil in this case, and C according to our notation. Then 590 kg, the solvent is there. So A plus C will be our RNP plus 1. We have estimated. Then XNP is equal to C by A plus C. 14 by this RNP is equal to 0.0232 we have obtained. Then afterwards, here also for the feed, we have found that F is equal to A plus C according to our formula. A plus C, 30 plus 365. Then YF, we found out C by A plus C, 365 divided by 30 plus 365 is equal to 0.076. And B is also there. So NF is equal to B by A plus C. So B is equal to 1000, 1000 divided by this 395. A plus C means 395. So something it will come. Then according to the problem, they have given these two data. So C is equal to, or a solute is equal to 55 kg, which is there in the extracted meal or extracted solid or inert or underflow, we can say. So C is there. Then B, whatever, now we are assuming that whatever the inert solids are there in the feed, all the inert solids are coming into the exhausted solids only. No contamination of this leached, strong leached solution. There is no contamination. So we are assuming like that. So now clue is only this one, C by B is there. So C by B, we have to match with this table parameters. Then we have to estimate what is the value of N and what is the value of Y by N something. So from the table itself, we calculated. This is, we just found that concentration, this one, kg oil per kg solution, which means kg C per A plus C. So this is Y. Then this is solution retained, which is kg solution means A plus C solution means. Then solids are B, A plus C by B. But according to our notation, N is nothing but B by A plus C. N is equal to B by A plus C. So we are reciprocating this one. So inverse, after inversing this one, we obtain this N values. Then Y by N. So according to our given data, which is in exhausted solids, we only have a clue that only C is equal to 55 kg is there. But from feed, we are assuming that all the feed solids which are after exhausting, all of them are going in the exhausted stream only. There is no contamination of leached solution. So because of that, B and C values are we are having. So C and B ratio is equal to this much we are coming. Then when we just cancel out the common parameters in Y divided by N, we will obtain C by B. So this is Y by N. So Y by N values, that's why we calculated. Then Y by V, according to our exhausted solid stream, is this 0.055. That value, so now we want what is the value of N. So this value, where it is falling according to the table, we have to identify that one. Then we identified that in between these two values only, this 0.055 value is falling. So by using the linear interpolation method, we will just estimate what is the in-between value at this value 0.055, what is the value of N according to this table. So interpolation we have used and found out that N value is 1.976. Then ENP is equal to, we know from the definition, B by N is equal to ENP. So B is constant, 1000 kg divided by just now N, whatever we estimated using interpolation method, we used this one. So 506 kg, which is A plus C. Then the left out parameters in that one is what is A in this one. So we can calculate A. How do we calculate here? Since this is A plus C, already C they have given 55 kg, 506 minus 55 is equal to 451 kg, which is only completely a solvent which is retained in the exhausted solid stream. So this much solid had been wasted. Okay. Then YNP. YNP is nothing but mole fraction of solute on a B-free basis. C by A plus C. So C we already there, 55 kg plus A plus C is nothing but this. ENP value 506.108. Then strong Richter solution. This strong Richter solution, nothing data has been provided as such. But we have to estimate indirectly because all the flow streams, according to this four stream, all this data we have calculated. These two data they have already provided. Using some formulas, we found out these values in this stream. Then we have to find out this one. So how to find out this one? By conducting a simple material balance for the solution, which is F plus RNP plus 1 is equal to R1 plus ENP, then we can find out this R1 value. Then after obtaining this R1 value, we can calculate what is the value of oil which is already retained in this oil which is there in, say, inside this strong solution. So how can we do that? All the three streams, all the four streams, oil is there. So by subtracting the oil which is there, by subtracting the oil which is there in this one, by adding this two, we just found out the value of C in this one, which is 324 kg. Then after that, we have estimated the mole fraction of solute in this raffinate stream, which is X1 is equal to C by A plus C, which is 324 divided by 493. So A plus C is nothing but RNP plus 1, this one, so 6.657. So now from the estimated data, we have summarized this point, this coordinate points F, YF, NF, which are these values, and RNP, at which the coordinate points are X, NNP, NP plus 1 and NNP plus 1. So these points are this one, and ENP, at which YNP and NNP, these points are this. Then R1.
Sir, YF. At the,
yes, Ravi?
YF is incorrect, sir. YF this value.
Okay.
0.924, sir.
924. Yeah, 365 divided by this 395.
0.924.
This value is wrong, or this values are something what wrong?
That last value is wrong.
Okay, calculation is wrong. Calculation is wrong. Okay, 0.924. 24. Okay, I hope you never used this one. Yes, anywhere we have not used this YF value.
Yes, sir. Nowhere we use YF. Okay.
Yes, yes. 0.924.
0.924, sir.
0.924. Okay, 0.924. Okay, we summarized these values. Then using this coordinate system, we have to plot on the graph. Since this delta R will be coming in the long range, so my small graph, which is there in the digital one, it is not enough. So because of this, I clubbed up all the four graphs. So somewhere in this region, we have to take our values. Okay. If this x-axis will be x comma y, or since this is there is no x values here, so only y values we can take, and this region will be n versus n values. This region will come y-axis, so n values will be ranging. So according to table, we will take n values. So n values are up to 2 it is coming. Okay, up to 2 means 0.5, 0.5 will take. Then okay, we will take this 0 point, and since this is our mole fractions, we will take up to 1. This is enough. So 0.1, this is 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, 1.0. So since these are mole fractions, we can take up to that 1. So this is 0 and 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5, like this, 3 will be there. Okay, this will be n values and these are y values. Then after that, we have to find out our points according to the table. Yeah, so then we have to plot n versus y. So n versus y will be first one, this one, n value 2, at which this is 0. This is 2 and y is 0. This is 1 point. Then 1.98, at which 0.1, y is 0.1. 1.98 and 0.1. So it will come here. Then 1.942 and 0.2. 1.94. This will take 1.98, nearly this can be equal to 2 only. Then 1.94, nearly 1.9 we will take, 0.2. Then 1.887, at that it is 0.3, 1.8. It will come here somewhat. Then 1.82 and 0.4. 0.4, 1.8, this one. Then 0.5, 1.75. 0.5, 1.75. It will be coming here. Then 0.6, 1.681. 1.6, 81 means until 7 it will come. Then 0.7, 1.613. 613, 1.6 will be somewhat here. Okay, now we have to join these points. Okay, we have joined this point. So this will be known as your N versus Y. So here there is no x-axis. So x points are not at all given. So only this N versus Y will be there. So after that, we have to locate our points. Four different points are there. So according to our procedure, any three points are needed in order to evaluate the number of plates. But here, because due to the lack of this distribution curve. Why? Because x-axis data is not there, x data is not there. So distribution curve is not there. We cannot find using the tie lines. So for that one, we have to, we already estimated the, all the four streams data we already estimated. Now we have to input a value of F. So what is F, Ravi, can you tell me?
0.924,
okay.
2.532.
Okay. Hi sir. Hi sir.
9 to 4.
5 3 2. Ravi. 2.5. Okay. 5 3 Ravi.
Yes sir.
Okay. 5 3 means it will only come this one only. This point is F. F is nothing but 0.924, 2.531 something. Okay. Then the next point is RNP. RNP is what, Ravi?
0.0232.
0.02. Okay. 02. This one and 0, no? That one RNP. NNP, NNP plus 1. So this point is called as F point.
RNP.
Yeah. So this point is RNP plus 1, whose coordinates are x-axis 0.02, comma 0.0. Then next one is ENP. What is ENP, Ravi? Coordinates?
ENP 0.1087.
0.108. Okay, 1. And 1.9763. 0.1. It will come around this region. You have to draw your physical graph, then only you come to know. Then next one is R1.
0.657.
Then?
0, sir.
0. 658. So this one is R1, 0.65, comma 0, and this one is R, no, ENP. ENP coordinates are 0.108, comma
1.973.
correctly. 97 is 1.9 only. So this region only it will come. Then afterwards, now in the previous case, what we have discussed is after drawing these two diagrams, which is x and y, then xy and this is n. So we have to locate this F point, then RNP point, then one more point is required, which is ENP point. So these three points are NF. Then what we have done, another point from the, we have calculated YM and NM, which is nothing but M point, midpoint. So here there is no distribution curve. Using that midpoint only, first we just connected these two, then we connected this and we extended this and we refer this to R1. Then we connected these two and extended these two and we connected these two and extended like this. So why? Because here M point, some midpoint is there. So using that midpoint, if this is R1, if the distribution curve is there, we are going like this up to the distribution curve and diagonal, and we are once again going upside, which is N versus Y curve. So here there is no such a condition because there is no distribution curve. So that condition will not apply here. So simplify, to simplify this one, now what we have to do, we have to connect this with R1, F with R1, then ENP with RNP. So nothing but our, according to our derivation, if you consider this F and this is RNP plus 1 and this is ENP, then this is R1. The difference point is nothing but F minus R1 is equal to ENP minus RNP plus 1. So F minus R1, ENP minus R1 is nothing but difference point. The meaning of that one is this one only. So that we have to connect with a straight line. So a long graph you need for this one. So at least x-axis it needs to be 20, I counted, and y-axis needs to be 26 boxes. Then only you are going to come this. I wasted 10 graphs after that. I come to know that one. Here we have to draw. Then only the delta R will be meeting. So this one will be like this. Somehow observe the procedure, I can't able to connect accurately that points. You want long scale in solving this one during the examination also, you want very long scale. Here it is connecting this point. Is called delta R point. How accurately you can locate the delta R point, depending on that only the values will be coming. Okay, now if you see I just deviated from that value, so this will also cause some difference. So accurately I can't locate that point. You just observe, but procedure you just observe, and in the physical paper with a long scale you can calculate, you can just find not out enough. Accurately. Which not enough?
One graph is not enough, sir.
Yeah, for me it is enough. I shared in this one in the WhatsApp. Okay, I don't know, the last line is touching or not also, I don't know.
No sir, not touching sir, just one box case it is left.
Yeah, one box I too wanted that one. Okay, you have to think on that one. So large graph you have to take for these problems. So that's why I advise you not to start this type of problems. If something you struck means that's it. Half an hour will be wasted unnecessarily.
But process is easy, no sir.
Process?
Process is better than writing theory, no sir.
Yeah, process they are giving. One question they are giving at least. Process, write about this derivation and step-by-step procedure. That is easy.
Yes.
So now we will do this one. So. Okay, now afterwards, what we have to do? This one is nothing but R1 already we have. Now vertically we have to project this value up to the n versus y axis, nothing but a tie lines. Now to draw a tie lines will be different in the previous case. In the previous case, these two cases, what happened when you connect F and R1? So this R1 you have to just go up to the equilibrium curve and then you have to go. So this will be called as your operating line. So one is tie line and another one is the operating line. Now here there is no difference between the operating line and tie line. So you have to vertically project up to the n versus y axis this one. Then like this. You have to project. So this is a tie line which is directly a vertical straight line. Then here it is called E1. Now after obtaining this E1, you have to connect this E1 to the delta R. So wherever this E1 during connecting it touches, there it is R2. So that we have to connect once again. So this is E1. So this one is now this one is R1. I connected maybe accurately. So this point needs to be started from here. So this one is E1. Then where it touches here, so this point is called as R2 now. Then afterwards, from this R2, you have to project it vertically until it reaches N versus Y curve. So this will be called as your E2. Then after that, once again, this E2 line, you have to connect with the delta R. This one. So from here it has to connect like this. So where it touches here in the bottom, that point is called as R3. So here it is called as this is R3 now. Then once again, here you have to once again project it vertically. Then this region is called as E3. Then once again you have to connect to the delta R. That connection point where it touches on N versus x-axis or x-axis, it is called as E4. So this one is R4. Like this, same you have to project once again. There it is called E4. Then once again you have to connect this. So up to like this, your NP you will obtain 6 stages you will obtain. So like this, when you do in a physical graph, it will be somewhat comfortable rather than doing it online. Okay, is it okay? Everybody understood this one? I tried my level best. I can't do anything via online. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Anybody is having any doubt, you can ask me, or otherwise I will move to the next topic. That's it. This is what I can do. Shall I move?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Up to where we have to extend, sir?
Up to where is ENP? Up to ENP point. Or it's somewhat, it crossing means is also okay. Up to ENP, you have to evaluate that point. So this is, so according to the previous procedure only, same thing, but due to the lack of this graph, so which is X versus Y graph.
Yes, sir, 6 stages I got, sir.
Yeah, 6 stages you will get. Previous same procedure, nothing different, only due to the lack of this X versus Y graph, we are using a separate method, which is directly joining this F with R1, and it is directly we have all the 4 points we have. All the 4 points we have. So we are directly joining with R1 and this ENP with this RNP plus 1 and joining directly with delta R, then whatever the points, all the vertical tie lines you will get. So rather than this type of tie lines, and this is called, this dotted lines is called as a operating line. So from R1 to this operating like this up to the distribution curve, and from the to the diagonal, and then once again to the N versus Y curve. Because of that, it is called as an operating curve, but these are called as tie lines. So here the tie lines are same with a vertical, all are vertical here, rather than being a touching to the equilibrium curve or distribution curve, all are vertical, we directly project this one. It's the only difference in this one. This one also up to ENP you have to calculate. For the problem also up to ENP only you have to calculate. Okay, if your ENP is coming here and somewhat the stage is going beyond this one, that is also okay. You can count that as a one stage because there is no 5.6 stage or 5.7 stage. Okay, we have to nearest digit you have to choose that one. So yes. Six stages you will going to get in this one. So this one is one type of problem. Then the case two is if you have a concentration, if final concentration, you want that one, final concentration, then they have to mention you what is the number of stages or final concentration or ENP or RNP, ENP or this RNP, not RNP, R1. If they want, they have to give you this number of stages. Then how to calculate that number of stages? They will give this number of stages already. So they we have you have to calculate ENP first. Okay, the same graphical procedure. So same one, we don't know, we know number of stages, but we don't know what is the value of ENP. In such case, what you have to do? First, you have to assume what is the value of ENP. Okay, ENP will be falling in this region only because when F is starting here means ENP will fall towards nearer to this point. If that is not falling towards this nearest point means that a leaching process is not at all efficient. So you have to choose nearest value ENP. Then you have to proceed in the same manner up to the ENP. And whatever the stages you got, you have to count that one. If your given data ENP, that number of stages is six stages, up to ENP, whatever you assumed up to ENP, if you are getting six means the two are matching, six is equal to six, you have assumed. Assumed six is equal to already given six number of plates, number of stages. So your assumed ENP is correct. If not, you have to change your assumption ENP. So that type of problem will be very rare, that one. So that one is very critical. So instead of that one, this type of problems now we solve, that is very commonly given in your examinations. So I hope you understood this one. Number of stages they will give. They will ask us to, yes, Ravi?
Yes, to also, did they give some time also?
No. Only procedure and one problem only I have seen this one. So if you find any additional problem, just message me, I will see.
We need 3-4 graph sheets to do this case too.
Yes. That they will not give. But when they are giving also, don't attempt this one. So yes, half an hour to 1 hour, it will go on just locating this graph only. Okay, my data, if you see my graph, this one, okay, 10 sheets I just wasted. So 10 sheets like this I wasted. After that, I came to know that, okay, this is not interconnecting. This delta R is not at all interconnecting. Then somehow I adjusted that one. So in exam, wasting that much time is not at all good. So first 3 units, just look it completely, and second 2 units, the 3-4 units, just this discussion procedure will be there. In the next unit also, procedures are there. Procedures is very, very, very important rather than these problems. Okay, yes. When you are having a free time, then you can just study this one, problem solving. But in examination, it is not at all good to start this one. Okay, then this is ENP you have to assume in this case whenever they asked us to calculate recovery or the final concentration. Okay, final concentration of this strong leached solution or whatever the unrecovered matter is there in the ENP also, they asking like that. So you have to do this procedure. First, you have to assume ENP, then you have to draw the plates. If that plates is matching with the given number of plates, your assumption of ENP is correct. You can apply the material balance and find out all the unknown parameters. But if your ENP, assumed ENP is wrong according to the number of plates, then you have to change your ENP assumption. Then only you can know. So 4 to 5 iterations it will take usually. So best not to start this one. Then next one is if solvent amount is needed. Okay, if you need RNP plus 1. So what you will do? The same one, assume some solvent fluoride. So some solvent fluoride RNP you have to assume. check whether ENP and the stages matches. Then ENP will be there. One of the input, okay, RNP plus one is nothing but input, solvent input. So that solvent input itself you don't know, means what you will do, that parameter you have to assume. Then you have to draw the stages. You have to compare with that stages. If the stages are matching, your assumed RNP is correct. If it is not matching, your RNP is wrong. The same one will be there.
Sir, but by...
I think, yes. Yes, Ravi?
This balancing... From balance we can get, no sir, RNP plus one ENP.
No, we will not get that one. So this is ENP. So what I missed?
From overall balance, solute balance.
Overall solute balance?
No sir, from overall balance and solute balance, from those equations we might get RNP plus one ENP.
ENP will also be not be given in that one. Solvent amount you have to calculate only. See, in this type of problems, only four streams are there. Okay, only here the four streams are there. Out of these four streams, any three they have to give.
Yes, sir.
That's okay. Any three they have to give, but they will deliberately leave any two one. Like in the previous case, they asked us to calculate ENP, but they will miss one of the three one. In next case, they asked us to calculate one input, then they will miss in the out of three, they will miss any one of them. F may be miss, R1, F usually F will not be missed, R1 or ENP will not be given, along with this RNP plus one also. So in that case, how do you calculate whatever the unknown parameter is there? First start, whatever they just asked us to calculate, if they are asking us to calculate solvent flow rate, this one we have to assume. If they are asking us to calculate this ENP, then this one we have to assume. Whatever they are asking, from that only we have to guess, that is what we are going to guess. From that only trial and error method we have to start.
If they asked us to calculate solvent and if they give these x values, we can calculate m, sir.
M we calculate, yes. Yeah, if we x and m, then n x y values are there, you can calculate.
Then almost we can get the RNP, no sir, if we know m.
M?
If we know the value of m, then we can get the RNP plus one value, no sir.
Yes. Then some data they will miss. I am generalizing that one, some data they will miss. So in that data, if they ask the two points, it whatever they are missing, whatever they are asking us to calculate, so the required data for that one will be not enough. When the required data is not enough, means there are two procedure in your hand. One is this type of procedure. When they are not giving this x-axis data, then whatever now we used in the problem, that type of procedure you have to calculate. Only two procedures are there. One is this type of procedure. When this type of procedure they are giving, whatever the required properties, whatever the required values are there for M, they will give that one. When there is no required data for calculating M, you have to go for whatever the procedure we adopted in the problem right now. Yes. So that's one. So but here the guess values are, what they are asking is the guess value for you. If they are asking ENP, means you have to start with ENP by guessing that one. If they are asking RNP plus one, means you have to start with RNP plus one. Then you have to match with that corresponding ENP and RNP. Is that okay?
Sir, but I think we can do the, we can somehow calculate, sir.
Calculate?
We can somehow, without assuming only, we can calculate exactly, sir, somehow.
No, not at all. But this type of problems I never seen, but only procedure is there in the textbook itself. Yes, procedure, sir. Means this one only they have given in the small paragraph. That's it. The problems also, there are no much problems in this type of category. Only yes. This type of problems are there. Since already we are solved, the procedure is there already, we can solve easily. But yes. Problem what now we solved is the different procedure. So because of that advantage, I take that problem. So okay, only two procedures are only there. You need not to worry. If they are giving the complete data which is required to evaluate by this procedure, you can easily follow this point. If they are not giving the X and Y, this data X axis, you can follow the procedure which now we have undertaken that one. That's
yes.
It. Yeah. Then next one is a minimum solvent requirement. So what is this minimum solvent requirement? For single stage, if you see the first stage, when we are giving this solvent, so the minimum requirement, something minimum requirement will be there for the given recovery. So that minimum requirement, how can we find that one? So it is a specific solvent quantity at which operating line becomes a tie line. So F, R, when whatever we are matching, all or nothing but a tie line. Rather than we are saying that as a operating line in this problem itself. So these are nothing but a tie lines and operating line also this one only. Compared to this previous case, so this one, if you see, so this is a tie line for them. So this is the dotted lines are operating line. If you see the vertical straight lines are nothing but an operating line for them as well as a tie line for them only in the minimum solvent requirement case. So these are very rare one. No problems we cannot find in this one. But you have to remember like this. That's it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Then next one is analysis of constant underflow system. So constant underflow system. What is this constant underflow system? Only this ENP. So depending on this ENP value only, our number of stages are going to affect. Okay, this is the yardstick we can say. So this is going to form a basis for calculation of number of stages. If this is varying, so we can find these plates using this procedure. If this is not at all varying, okay, if it is constant means some value will be there, some quantity, some value will be there for that one. Under this case, directly one of the other, which is Kremser-Brown and Soder's equations, these others already formed this equation. So this will be known as Kremser-Brown and Soder equation. Using this equation, you can directly found what is the values, unknown parameter values. So this one is YF. We already know that YF means mole fraction of this solute on B-free basis. Then YNP is nothing but in extract phase, on the last stage, what is the value of this weight fraction of solute on B-free basis? And Y1 is in first stage, what is the value of, after passing to the first stage, what is the value of this C in terms of mass fraction? Then M means, so this one, R and E is there, so R and E. So not this case, okay, R and E. Okay, this one, E1 and R2, wherever it matches the slope of this line, slope of this, in that case, tie lines will be same as this operating line. So because of that advantage, any line you consider, slope of that equation is nothing but M. So R by E, R and E, whatever the line is there, how much inclination that slope will be provided in the problem itself. If you have all these unknown parameters, whatever the unknown parameters, if they don't give this YNP, then we can calculate this one. So this is also out of context for your syllabus. This out of interest, I'm just telling you. Just remember that for constant underflow problem, it is very, very easy to determine the number of stages. So before determining the number of stages, we can apply this formula to calculate the unknown parameters. This formula is known as Kremser-Brown and Soder equation. Okay, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Then different types of equilibrium diagrams. So equilibrium diagrams, now we know that this is N versus XY, and this will be dependent. The operation of this N versus XY diagram will be constantly dependent on this one, distribution curve, X versus Y. So depending on these types, there are different types, 3 to 4 types are there. So how they dependent? So this type of trend will be obtained. So this is a tie line. To draw this tie line, we have to assume some value in the X axis. Then we have to pass it until it reaches, extend it until it reaches the equilibrium curve and the distribution curve. Then we have to pass it horizontally, extend it horizontally until it reaches 45 degrees diagonal and towards vertically until it reaches N versus Y graph. So separately, if you see here, N versus X is also there for this one. So this type of trends, when do we observe this type of trend? So this type of curves will be observed when preferential adsorption of a solute occurs on the solid. So whatever the solute is there, preferentially, the maximum adsorption of that oil will be there with the solids only. So maximum amount of that oil will be just retaining with the solids only. It is very tough to extract that one. This type of curves will be obtained. Then solute is soluble in the solid B and distributes unequally between liquid and solid phases at equilibrium. So at equilibrium, what happens, this the solute which is coming out, the leaching, the main aim of the leaching is we have to separate out maximum amount of solute in the solvent, this solvent rich phase, or we can say this one solution, strong leached solution. But rather than being as such case, it is very unequally distributed. So very much unequal distribution will be there in between solid and liquid phases. Then only we can observe this one. And insufficient contact between solute and solvent is resulted. Okay, when seeds are going with the oil, then it is contacted with some benzene or hexane with a short period of time, insufficient contact time. What happens? The maximum amount of solvent with a lean amount of this solute will be coming to the output. In that case, this type of curves will be obtained. And EF is a tie line. In this one, EF is a tie line. We know this one. So this type of curves is a tie line. For the basis of this tie line angle is this X versus Y curve. This one and type 2. Okay, type 2 like of curves. As such, we have seen this one. N versus X axis will be this X axis only, where there is no solids in this raffinate phase. Okay, in the clear solution phase or a strong leached phase, no solid amount is present. All the solids are going into the inert stream, inert solid stream. Then this type of curves will be obtained. For this type of curves, so other characteristics are no adsorption of solute occurs. There is no adsorption of solute at all. Only solute retains inside that solid material. That's it. When some solvent is coming into contact, it will easily, from the interstices, the solvent can be impinged into that one and can be extracted easily. Then solution withdrawn and solution associated with the solid have the same composition. So whatever the solution withdrawn and solution already associated with the solids have the same composition. Okay, this what we say, X1 and RxNP, RNP, RNP plus 1, YNP plus 1, and XNP will be having the same values for this type of curves. Then only this tie line will be vertical, straight tie line. So okay, that type of stages will be act as a dummy stages. For dummy stages also, we will obtain this type of tie lines. Okay, straight tie lines rather than an inclined one, straight tie lines will be obtained. So tie lines are vertical. So very much vertical will be there. They will not have any inclination. So the distribution coefficient is unity. So distribution coefficient is nothing but how much amount of solute is coming in the raffinate phase, how much amount of solution which is going into the extract phase, divided by extract phase, Y by X we can say. Y by X is nothing but distribution coefficient. So distribution coefficient, the usage of this distribution coefficient is very limited in the leaching problem, but the usage of distribution coefficient is very much in the extraction type of problems. So you will see that distribution coefficient used in the next unit, extraction problems. Then solids are drained at the to the same extent at all solute concentration, and such a condition is known as constant underflow conditions. In the constant underflow conditions also, this is the tie lines, this type of tie lines only will be coming. At the same time, when there is no solids in the strong leached stream, this type of tie lines only will be coming. When there is a solids in this one, the tie lines will be somewhat inclined. Then no B is present in the solution, either dissolved and or suspended. So there is no B which is present in the dissolved or this suspended solids amount. Then next one is a type 3. Okay, this is very, very, very rare type of isotherm. We can say this one characteristics of this type of curves, equilibrium curves. So a typical trend N versus Y will be like this only. then solute C has a limited solubility. So solute, whatever the solute composition is there, there will have a very limited solubility. They are not at all, the distribution coefficient will be very, very less among this solvent and this leached solids. Then only this type of curves will be obtained. All this one, if you see, this is one type of tiling, this H2E one type of tiling, G2E one type of tiling. Now it is coming, E to F is a straight line. So this type of unpredictable behavior will be there in this type of tilings. So the tiling joining slurry and saturated curve converge as shown. So this will be converging with all the tilings. Then till the concentration of excess is reached, the saturation concentration. So excess saturation concentration reaches, till that one, this type of behavior will be upturned. And after reaching that saturation concentration, the tilings will be vertical like this. So this type of curves are very, very rare. So these are the three types of isotherms are there. So this is not there. Nowhere I can observe this type of isotherms in your question paper. They are not asking much in your question, whole question papers. But better to study this one also. Only you have to just remind this one how these are drawn. You already know from the single stage extraction, leaching operation, and multi-stage cross current and multi-stage counter current also. You know how to draw this graph. Just draw this one. You remember how these curves will be look like. So N versus X will be there when there is some solids which is contaminating this clear leached solution. There will be no N versus Y separately rather than this X-axis itself when there is no solid contamination in the leached solution. When there is a solid contaminant in the leached solution, you will obtain a separate N versus X curve. When there is no solid contamination in the leached solution, then you will obtain the x-axis as your N versus X curve, X line or X curve, whatever it may be. So that's you have to remember. And this is a completely unpredictable equilibrium diagram, we can say, because of this saturation and everything. Everything will be just converging with each other. So unpredictable, this one. So this is your unit 4. If you have any doubt, you can just go through to ask the doubts. Otherwise, from the next class, we will start Unit 5. Yes, Ravi, you said something, I guess. I can't hear you.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that is what for today. And Unit 4 is this. So you can just refer the old question papers if you have anything I have not covered, you can just intimate me, I will cover. Otherwise, if you are interested more in solving problems, if something is there in your old question paper, you can just verify that one. If nothing, you cannot solve that one, come to me, we'll try to solve. Okay, I will also try that one. This, I will share the PDF.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's it. Notes already there for the Unit 5 also in the Teams and as well as WhatsApp also. I send the notes Unit 5. Then this one PDF I will send. That's it. This leaching problems also I send this one.
Yes,
okay, PPT also I will convert to PDF and I will send. Okay, that's it for
today. Sir.